when people think about threatened species, they think about bilbies and wombats. But in fact, most of our threatened species are plants. And until recently, we've really had no idea how they're going as a group.
The Threatened Plant Index combines data from all around Australia from more than 100 monitoring programs and brings it all together in one place so that we can track change in the abundance of threatened plants over time. Our overall finding is that threatened plants have declined by 70% overall over the last few decades. Now, we've actually broken up the Threatened Plant Index to look at specific groups in more detail, like orchids or trees, and see if they differ in their trends over time. And what's interesting is that overall, all of these groups are declining at pretty much the same rate. There is some good news though. Plants that are in sites that have been intensively managed are doing better than plants that haven't been managed at all.
Management does work. Intensive management works really well. Some of our plants are starting to recover, of our threatened plants. On average, the trend is down, and it's not a great story.
The more data that we have, the more representative this index can be, and the stronger it can be in terms of telling us how our plants are doing and where we need to allocate our investment into the future. Now, the data that have come into the Threatened Plant Index have come from all of the Australian states and lots of citizen science and community organisations. But unfortunately, we don't have data on threatened plants from all over Australia. The bulk of that information has actually just come from four states, with South Australia representing almost half of the data in the entire index. Even though South Australia doesn't have the most threatened species of all of the states in Australia, it's great to see that it's pushing above its weight in terms of how much threatened species monitoring is happening there, in particular for plants. We can add data every year, and we really encourage all of the organisations, community groups and researchers who are interested in threatened plants to get out there, either continue counting threatened plants or start new threatened plant monitoring index.
If we don't have an index and we don't count these threatened species, we'll never know whether we're having an impact. So the long-term monitoring across multiple species, across all the different states, is an incredibly important part of determining whether this investment by state and federal government and community groups is really working.